Hello friends, in my this video I am going to discuss circular shift of array elements in the clockwise direction. Okay, so what is that? So the program is basically very simple. I am going to show you first the algorithm, and I am going to implement the same algorithm in MATLAB as well as in Java. Okay, so suppose you consider this example 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, and required amount of shift D is equal to 3. These are the two inputs which you are taking from the user. Now you see, in clockwise direction, if the array element rotates circularly, what you will get? See, the first three elements will go to end. So as this is circular shift, so first one will go here after 7, then 2 will go after shifted 1, and 3 will go at the end after this 2, and the new sequence you will get as 4 5 6 7 1 2 3. Okay, similarly, if you consider 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then what will happen? When rotated by two elements, it will become 3, 4, 5, 1, 2. Okay, because we are rotating by two elements. So that 3, 4, 5. So so first 1 will come after 5 and 2 will come after shifted 1. And they will get this sequence. Okay, so obviously, if you consider the algorithm, step 1 is you have to take inputs from the user. Right? Now, this step 2 you consider, we will form another array and we will store the numbers accordingly. This is what we are going to follow. Although this is not a very memory efficient programming, because we have to use another array, but it will work at least. Okay, you can use such algorithms which will more be space efficient, or time complexity for which will be reduced. You can check using the data structure concepts, but I am going to show you one simple program so that you can easily understand. Okay, so suppose you are considering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 this array, and you want to shift by two elements, then what will happen? You are getting this array 3, 4, 5, 1, 2. Now suppose you have created one array B which is of same array length of the input array, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there is this array length 5. Now what will happen? We can say that array elements, that is B of I equal to C, you just consider from this part, okay, after the shifted part, the all the numbers are printing just like sequentially. Okay, so suppose you want to shift by two elements, so shift from 3 to last, all the elements for the input are basically coming in the first part of the B array. Okay, so this is the concept what we are going to use. See, let me show you in MATLAB, then it will be very clear. So suppose x equal to input, then enter the array elements, okay, then bracket close, then what we are doing for then we have to take what is the required amount of shift also. So D equal to input, enter the required amount of shift. Okay, so first shifting is amount of shift is also taken, then what we are doing for I equal to D plus 1 colon length of x. Why I have taken like this? See, this is the array 1 2 3 4 5, required amount of shift is 2. So see, from the 3 to end of the input array, what is happening? All the elements are coming in the front side of the output array B, you can say like this. Okay, so as in MATLAB, array index start from 1. So what we will do, we will put here B of k. Okay, sorry, let me okay, right, or y of k equal to a of I. Okay, that means in y array, a of I, which is basically a of d plus 1, then a of d plus 2, then a of d plus 3, up to end it will store. Okay, so what you can do, you can increment increment the array index of our main array which we are going to print. That is why we are doing like this, k equal to k plus 1, end this, and here as in MATLAB, array index start from 1, so define k equal to 1. Okay, that's all. Now see what is happening. We already has taken care of the next part. Now see what is happening. The initial part, the that is the array index up to which one we want to shift, that is coming at the end. Okay, so what we want to, what we have to do, like similar kind of thing, for I equal to you can do like this. So 1 colon d, because already from d plus 1 to length of x we have done, our job is done. Now 1 to d, what we have to do? Y of k equal to k of I. Okay, k equal to k plus 1. K will go on like normal method, but y of k will be k plus I. I hope if you write down, you can easily understand. If you can check also, so display y. Okay, let me show you. Control A, evaluate, selection, enter the array elements. Suppose let me give the same array input 1 2 3 4 5 and required amount of shift is 2. 1 2 3 4 5, required amount of shift is 2. See what you are getting, this complex numbers, why it is coming. Okay, let me clear this. Okay, let me show you again. So first control A, then evaluate selection, enter the array elements 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, enter the required amount of shift 2. See undefined variable A. Okay, so oh sorry, this is input is x, sorry. So this is x of, it will be x. Okay, sorry. Now let us check again. 5, enter the required amount of shift is 2, undefined function or variable A. So what we can do here, that see here, this will be x. So please CLC, control A, evaluate selection, enter the array elements 1 2 3 4 5, enter the required amount of shift 2. See 3 4 5 1 2. What was our target array output? 3 4 5 1 2. So our code is perfectly working. Let me show you. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 for d equal to 3. So control A, evaluate selection, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and record amount of shift is 3. See 4 5 6 7 1 2 3. See what was error? 4 5 6 7 1 2 3. So this particular MATLAB code is perfectly working. Last input let we can verify 1 5 6 4 7 8 9 13. Okay, 2. See 6 4 7 9 13 1 5. So this circular shift in clockwise direction is perfectly working for the MATLAB. But the matter of fact is that whatever algorithm you follow, it is same for different programming language. Now the same algorithm you can use in Java also. So let me show you. So first what we have done, we have taken input. So import java.util.scanner. Okay, then class shi for shift, then public static void main, then string string argument. Okay, then here create the object in the scanner class. So scanner obj equal to new scanner system dot in, then what you can do, system dot out dot println, enter the array length. In MATLAB you no need to think about array length, but here in Java you must have to think, otherwise you cannot form the array, right? So int n equal to obj dot next int method we have to call, then int create the array int a. Okay, we have taken in MATLAB, we have taken x array, so let me take same array name, int x equal to new int. New keyword is used because why? Because in Java we treat array as object, right? So for int I equal to 0, I less than array length n, I plus plus, then system dot, so what we are just taking in system dot out dot println println, enter the numbers num vars in the in the array. Okay, then so now what you can do, you can take inputs, right? So x of I equal to obj dot x of I equal to obj dot next int. Okay, then bracket close. So in this we have taken the input. Now we are taking the required amount of shift. So system dot out dot println enter the req required amount of shift in clockwise direction. Now what we have defined, k equal to 1. Why we have defined? Because in MATLAB array index start from 1, but in Java whether it is so? No, so it will start from 0, right? Don't mistake in these positions. For I equal to here d plus 1 colon length of x, so here what will be here, as array index start from 0 in Java, so d colon length of x minus 1. For I equal to d colon length of x minus 1, whether you can write like this? No, for I equal to, tell me 0, then I less than or equal to, no, actually I will start from d here, d and I less than equal to length of x minus, less than equal to length of x minus 1, I plus plus. What you can do? Here define int I equal to, now see y of k equal to x of I, so we have to make one array y of k also. So int y equal to new int n. Okay, same array length as, now here write y of k equal to, sorry, y of k equal to x of I. Okay, then k equal to k plus 1. Just I am copying from the MATLAB code, you no need to think, you understood the algorithm, take the same method. Now see next for loop, for int I equal to 0, sorry, I equal to 1 colon d in MATLAB, so that in Java it will be I equal to 0, I less than equal to d minus 1, basically d minus 1 I plus plus, or you can write here started from I equal to d, so that you can write I less than d also, no issue in that. Now y of k, again y of k equal to simply x of I, oh sorry, here it will be in third bracket, y of k equal to x of I. Okay, then k equal to again k plus 1, or you can write k plus plus in Java, no issue in that. So now this for loop ends. Now we have to print. So for int I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus, system dot out dot println y of I. Okay, y of I, bracket close, bracket close, bracket close, one bracket close for for loop, one bracket close for public static void main, one for class. Now here you can write the message also, system dot out dot println println the rotated rotated array is. Okay, that's all. Let's hope that our code should work. Control S, shi dot java. Now let us check in command prompt, so cd java, then java c shi. What was the function name? Class name shi, right? So shi dot java. Okay, let us see some error is there or not. Yes, error is there. For int I equal to d, variable d cannot find symbol. Why cannot find symbol? Whether we have not defined. Let me make it bigger. Enter the required amount of shift. Okay, so here we have not taken the input. So int d equal to obj dot next int. Okay, to take the input. What happened? Yeah. Here it will be control s. Okay, now what you can do, let us check again java c, then see one more error, I less than equal to length of x minus 1 cannot find symbol. Okay, so less than equal to length of x, len gth length of x minus 1 method length. Okay, sorry, in MATLAB we write like this. Here you have to write x dot L-E-N-G-T-H. Okay, control s, don't mess up the syntax commands in between MATLAB and Java. Now you can simulate, see Java shi, then enter the array length. Suppose let me take the example only, that is 1 2 3 4 5, so this array length is 5. Okay, so 5, then enter the number in the array, 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, enter the required amount of shift. What was the required amount of shift here in this case? Probably 2. Let me check. Yeah, by 2 elements. So 2, right? Enter. See, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2. Okay, so that, see, this is the array 3, 4, 5, 1, 2. Suppose you want to print in a single line, just very simple. Instead of println, you give system.out.print, and to give some, you have to give some space in this case. Then control s. Now let us check again. Java C, then Java, what was, let us check with another case, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and required amount of shift is 3, then we should get this array, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, let us check. So enter the array length, 7, then enter the element, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, enter the required amount of shift, 3, see, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3. So our Java code is also perfectly working. So see, you understand the algorithm, you implement in any programming language, just you have to know the syntax. So this is the Java program. Obviously, it will be a bit bigger than MATLAB, because MATLAB is very friendly, like input you can directly take in one line, but in Java you have to first import the scanner class, then you have to create the object in the scanner class, then you have to call the method next in, then you have to take input, like these kinds of some modifications are there. But overall, the algorithm is same. That is what the important point, and you should understand the algorithm. Don't try to memorize it. Understand it. If you are unable to understand at any line, you just ask in the comment section. Thank you for watching.